decades. Gore Vidal is one of America's most respected writers and thinkers, authored more than 20 novels, 5 plays. His recent books include Dreaming War, Perpetual War for Perpetual Peace, and Imperial America, Reflections on the United States of Amnesia. His latest is a memoir. It's called Point to Point Navigation. Last week at the Los Angeles Times Festival of Books, I heard Gore Vidal would be there, and afterwards went to his home in Hollywood Hills. We sat down in his living room, and I asked him for his thoughts on this election year and on the last 8 years of George W. Bush in the White House.
Well, it isn't over yet. You know, he could still blow up the world. There's every indication that he's still thinking about attacking Iran. I mean, the generals are now reporting that Iran are a great danger and their weapons are being used to kill Americans. I mean, you know, I think quite rightly the Bushites think that the American people are idiots. They don't get the point to anything. There are 2 good reasons for this. There's the public educational system for people, kids without money, let's say. To put it tactfully, is one of the worst in the first world. It's just terrible. And they end by knowing no history, certainly no American history. I didn't mean to spend my life writing American history, which should have been taught in the schools. But I saw no alternative but to taking it on myself. And I can think of a lot of cheerier things I'd rather be doing than analyzing George Washington and Aaron Burr. But it came to pass. That was my job, so I did it.
You wrote United States of Amnesia. Why?
That's a good title. You must remember, this is a people that has no culture.
You write 2 books during the Bush administration. 2 of the books you've written are Perpetual War for Perpetual Peace and Dreaming War. Why these 2?
Well, Perpetual War for Perpetual Peace, that's my main book during that period. That was the foreign policy of the Bush administration. Perpetual War. This is also Harry Truman's dream. He started the Cold War. If any history had been imparted to our people, they'd know all this. And if you think I enjoy being the one to tell them about it, I don't.
What about Dreaming War?
Well, same thing. They were dreaming war. You can see little Bush all along. It's just dreaming war. And also, and Cheney dreaming about oil wells and how you knock apart a country like Iraq, and of course their oil will pay for the damage you do. For that alone, he should have been put in front of a firing squad.
Do you believe in the death penalty?
No, but in their case, yes.
And so here we are, moved into the 6th year of the war with Iraq, longer than the U.S. was involved in World War II.
Yes, incredible. That was such a huge operation on 2 great continents against 2 modern enemies, and we're fighting little jungle wars for no reason. Because we have a president who knows nothing about anything. He's just blank. But he wants to show off. I'm a wartime president. I'm a wartime president. And he goes, yep, yep, yep. He's like a crazed terrier. And look where he got us. I didn't realize, I think I've always had a good idea about my native land, but I didn't think that institutionally we were so easy to overthrow. Because it was a coup d'etat, 9/11. It all went crashing. And when they got rid of Magna Carta, I thought, well, really, this wasn't much of a republic to begin with.
What do you mean, Magna Carta?
Well, you know what Magna Carta means? Yep.
Explain it.
Tell your viewers. It's the basis of our law. Out of it comes the whole theory, practice, on which our certainly judicial system is based. Due process of law. You cannot deprive somebody of life, liberty, pursuit of happiness. Because that is a right, constitutional right. And that is, I mean, every proper American, that's graved on his psyche. Certainly was on mine. There wasn't a day passed. I was brought up by my grandfather in Washington. There was hardly a day passed that he didn't want to talk about due process.
What do you mean, Gore Vidal, when you say you think what happened after 9/11 was a coup?
Well, it was. The first move they made at the time when Timothy McVeigh decided to blow up the federal building in Oklahoma City, he started to write me letters, and I wrote him back, and he's a brilliant kid, very interested in law, would have been made a good constitutional lawyer, and a patriot. He's a professional soldier. But he has to be depicted as a monster, because who else would blow up little children? But he didn't know he was blowing up any little children. He was acting out of a fit of rage at what had happened at Waco. And that whole religious community was set fire to by the army. And as a soldier, he thought to himself, you see, the one thing that divides our country from being another militarized republic, it is not only due process of law, but it is also the Posse Comitatus Act of 1875, which the army may not be used in any action against the citizens of the United States. And they just wander and bang, bang, they set fire to the place, burn down more children and mothers and so on than ever Mr. McVeigh did. So at that time, it happened during the, must have been, what's her name, Janet Reno, when she was Attorney General. It was during Clinton's watch, which was a sloppy one. And they got some panicky legislation, because they thought, and with some reason, that there was a group of people, many of them ex-soldiers, who were ready to overthrow the government. And they were anti-Semites, they were, I mean, anything you can think of, they were that. They were in rebellion against this country. And I wrote about it in warning terms. I went so far as to write Mr. Mueller, who was the new director of the FBI. And I saw he was never going to follow up. They did all these interviews with various guys living in the woods around Fort Hood. I said, they're going to be trouble one day. And you don't even follow up on them? Yet you go on inventing stuff about McVeigh, which isn't true. They tried to pretend he was a crazy and this and that. Well, he got the Silver Star, I think it was.
And the Persian Gulf War.
Yeah. So the coup d'etat comes out of this. They saw their chance. They, Cheney, Bush, they wanted a war. They're oil men. They want a war in which they'll get more oil. I mean, they're also extraordinarily stupid. These people don't know anything about anything. But they have this, it was a thick piece of sheet of, a thick series of actions to be taken. Among others, I think one of them was to lock up every person of color in the United States in order to protect us from the enemy within. It was evil stuff. So they latched on to that. I guess Mr. Gonzalez was already in place by then. And that was the coup d'etat. They seized the state. And from that moment on, they were appointing all the judges. They were doing this, they were doing that. They got rid of Magna Carta. I will not explain what that is a second time. And they broke the republic.